maximum and minimum problems with a focus on business and economics applications. Our objective is to solve maximum and minimum problems using calculus methods. Let's take a look at some guidelines or suggestions on how to solve these types of problems. Number one, of course, read the problem carefully and if possible, make a sketch. Number two, make a list of your variables and constants, including your units, and label your drawing if appropriate. Translate the problem into an equation that can be maximized or minimized. And lastly, and most importantly, we need to try to write the equation as a function of one variable. If we can do this, then we can use calculus methods to determine the maximum or minimum values and the points at which they occur. Let's go ahead and take a look at an example. Suppose you want to minimize q equals 2x squared plus 3y squared, given the constraint that x plus y must equal 5. So we want to minimize q equal to 2x squared plus 3y squared, given that x plus y must equal 5. We need to somehow write this equation in terms of one variable so we can find the derivative of it, find the critical numbers, and so on. The issue is, right now it's in terms of both x and y. However, if we go over here to the right and solve this for y, y is equal to 5 minus x, which means wherever we see a y, we can replace it with 5 minus x, which allows us to rewrite q in terms of x. Y is the same as 5 minus x. So we've done our substitution for y, and now we need to expand this, simplify it, and see what we have. This should be the 3. Combining like terms, our function q is equal to 5x squared minus 30x plus 75. If we want to minimize this, what we need to do is find the first derivative, set it equal to 0, and find our critical numbers. So if we set this equal to 0 and solve, we can see that x equals 3. This is where a maximum or minimum may occur. Now, to verify whether this would be a max or min, what we should do now is test x equals 3 into the second derivative and see what our concavity is. The second derivative of q is equal to positive 10, which means over its entire domain, this function is concave up. Therefore, at x equals 3, we must have a minimum, which is good news because we're trying to minimize q. So we have a minimum when x equals 3. Now we also have to find the y value to minimize q, but of course we can see that y is equal to 5 minus x, so y would have to equal 2. So let's go ahead and see what the minimum value of q would be by replacing x with 3 and y with 2. And it looks like q is going to equal 18 plus 12, or 30. So what we've discovered under this constraint, that q is minimized at 30. Let's take a look at another example. From a thin piece of cardboard 10 inches by 10 inches, square corners are cut out so that the sides can be folded up to make a box. What dimensions will yield a box of maximum volume, and what is the maximum volume? Okay, so let's make a drawing of what's actually happening here. Our square is 10 inches by 10 inches. We're cutting squares out of each corner. If we cut these squares out and fold these pieces up, you can see we'll have a box with no lid. Now, we don't know the size of the square that we're cutting here, so we're going to call it x inches by x inches. But they are squares, so they would all be x. Now what we have to do is recall what is the volume formula for this box. And the volume would equal length times width times height. We need to find the expression for each of these. Let's go back to this picture here. Now we need to figure out what would be the length of this piece here, because that is going to be the length of the piece here on this box, and the same thing here. Well, from this edge to this edge, we know is 10 inches. So in order to find this shorter length, we would have to take 10 inches minus this piece, which is x, and minus this piece, which is also x, which would give us 10 minus 2x. This distance would be 10 minus 2x. So with this distance here, and the height of the box would actually be the length x. Okay, so our volume formula is equal to 10 minus 2x times 10 minus 2x times x. And we want to maximize this. Let's go ahead and go to the next screen and expand this and then find the derivative. So we have the volume is equal to, again, 10 minus 2x times 10 minus 2x times x. Let's multiply the two binomials first. All of this times x. Okay, we need to find the critical numbers, so we need to find the first derivative and set it equal to 0. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and write this in descending order before I try to factor it. Now I will go ahead and factor this. If you want to pause the video and verify this, please feel free to do so. So the solutions x equals 5/3 and x equals 5. These are our two critical numbers. These are the x values for which we may maximize or minimize the volume. Of course, we want to maximize it. Before we move on, though, I'd like to take a look at the x value of 5. Let's go back to our drawing. If x was equal to 5, 10 minus 2x would actually be 0. Which doesn't make any sense. So 5 is actually not in the domain of this function. Therefore, we can exclude x equals 5. We need to consider x equals 5/3. To determine if we have a relative max or min at that value, we should find the second derivative. So let's go ahead and do that. The second derivative would be equal to, here's our first derivative, negative 80 plus 24x. Now if we evaluate the second derivative at 5/3, you can pause again and test it, but it's going to be less than 0, meaning it's negative, which means the function is concave down at that value. Therefore, we would have a maximum value when x equals 5/3. That's good news. We're trying to maximize our volume, and it will be maximized when x equals 5/3. So the question asks for the dimensions of maximum volume. And remember, the dimensions were 10 minus 2x by 10 minus 2x by x. Replacing x with 5/3 here would give us 20/3 by 20/3 inches by 5/3 inches. These are the dimensions that would maximize the volume, and the maximum volume, of course, would equal the product, 2,000 divided by 27 inches cubed, which is approximately 74.08. I'd like to take a look at the graph of the volume function just for a moment.